Kneeling Anthem scumbags horrified with what just showed up on the sidelines during their protest. Despite the dramatically decreasing attendance, NFL games still go on weekly regardless if there's anyone there to see them and the protests that come with it. Entitled players seem to completely ignore the harsh reality of their anti-American rhetoric, seen in the empty seats that surround them that seem to be more than fans who still come to see them play. Just when the league had reached rock bottom, Kneeling Nation Anthem scumbags were horrified when they saw what was dramatically different on the sidelines in the middle of their disgusting protest. People watching the demise of what was once America's favorite sport were as equally shocked as the disrespectful players to see what suddenly happened seconds after the Star-Spangled Banner began, which they definitely weren't expecting. The league has allowed these divisive antics to go on for so long that it's completely destroyed the sport for everyone, which doesn't seem to bother the NFL commissioner who refuses to change course despite the utter destruction. However, not everyone is taking a passive approach to the problem, and now the issue is coming back to haunt every kneeling player who thinks they have something important to say. Whether you're boycotting the NFL or simply just avoiding it if you can, there's one scene from these games that deserving of your attention if you love America but still hate the NFL. This isn't to get viewership back in the game lost by entitled protesters who act like they don't care if anyone is watching or not. It makes a statement loud and clear that can't even be ignored by the most arrogant athletes on the field. While players were taking a knee to make a point, they miss the massive message on the sidelines that's much bigger than them. They think they have the experience to make the statement they have, at the cost of their industry, but the man who lost his legs for their right to kneel trumps their statement any day. He can't kneel and wouldn't anyway, he can barely even stand, but he used his arms to pull himself out of his chair and stood strong and proud in his exoskeleton to send a message that can't be beaten by everyone on their knee. In a video which surfaced on Instagram showing a military veteran making sure all the players in the stadium know how it's done, the hero without legs demonstrated patriotism in epic proportion to those who needed a clue. Clearly, these overpaid players need to see what sacrifice looks like, real work, dedication, and coming out of all of that and still being capable of respecting the flag. He lost his legs protecting players' right to kneel that he doesn't have, to protest equality. He's not equal in physical stature to these athletes with legs, but he more than makes up for their major lack of respect by earning 10 times what they're deserved, with half the body they have. The fact that he gets up in the position he is in to stand after getting blown up while fighting for this country and these million-dollar athletes who haven't been told no or that they're wrong in years because they superstars kneel? One Instagram user commented on the post. It's just sad. We need to come together. Not separate. Kneeling for the flag isn't protesting SHT. Just dividing a country that needs to come together. This country has its problems, but it's still the best place to live with the most opportunities, work hard, pay your taxes and be a good person and you can get anything you want in this country. The players should know this more than the rest of America still working hard to reach their goals. These young guys in their 20s are protesting issues as if they're at some lack of advantage of anything while reaping the rewards of actual advantages most Americans, of any race, will ever experience. It's insulting to see these guys with the world at their fingertips act like they are stifled somehow because of their skin color when the guy without legs knows the stifling price of freedom but stands anyway. It's time to start seeing these players and their protests for what they really are. These guys are nothing more than actually privileged millionaires who are overpaid for playing the game. They're malcontents who are not concerned with protecting the league that from demise and as a result has slapped the hand who feeds them. As fast as that money came, it can and will go away, when respect given is not returned. They aren't as courageous and heroic as those getting paid pennies to run from bullets on the battlefield. They hurt a wrist and take time off from their sport, but it literally takes a soldier losing limbs to be out of the game.